Sandal, Real Tight Fishing. Today we are at Georgetown, right here in DC, near the Kennedy Center. Going out for some catfish today. I got Kool-Aid chicken with garlic. We're gonna throw that on. I got two rods with me. I got my bait caster. I'm gonna throw a swim bait out, something, see if I could get into something with that. And we're gonna get it cracking. If you're new to my channel and you happen to like this video, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe, drop a comment down below. Let me know if there's anything I can do better, anything I could do better to improve, whether it be my camera placement or baits or anything. Just drop a comment down below, positive or negative. Super fast like that. Alright guys, so we got our lines in now. For those of you who know about catfish, it's just pretty much a waiting game from now. So in the meantime, I'm gonna come on over here, I'm gonna throw the bait caster out, and see if I can hit anything. Alright guys, so I'm right here on the, this is actually where Rock Creek drops into the Potomac. Look up that way behind this tree right here. That's Rock Creek. There's the Potomac on this side. I got a Storm Chartreuse swim bait on right now. I believe this is a 4-inch. Throw that out. That bet.
think that may have popped. Yeah, it definitely popped. Alright guys, so we just lost the swim bait. So now I got a, says a 1/4 ounce jig head. I'm not sure what brand of lure this is, but let's just say maybe it looked like a, looked something like an eel, maybe, or a worm. I'd say more like an eel. It's about, I wanna say 6 inches. Yep. Throw that out there. Definitely do look like an eel in the water. I mean, if I was a fish, I'd probably eat it. I'm not too sure if I'm fishing this the correct way, but I'm trying to like retrieve it fast enough so it don't get caught up on anything on the bottom, but still jig it, like give it jerks. Alright guys, so it's been like about 20 minutes now since my line snapped on me. Not getting any hits with the catfish, so I decided to tie a spinner bait up here to finish that off with a 3-inch red shiner swim bait. Get at a simple retrieve. Try not to get snagged on anything. Thank you.
last spot, we ain't catch nothing. Didn't even get a nibble. So right now I'm at a new spot, maybe about a mile and a half down river from where I was just at. I'm actually in, I'm gonna say West Potomac Park. So not Haynes Point, but I'm outside of Haynes Point on West Potomac Park, near the tidal basin. So we got about maybe 2 hours of sunlight left before it get dark. Whole bag for the bait left. I didn't bring the bait cast out with me this time, but hopefully we get on some fish here.
I went with the larger size bait on that rod, and on this rod here I went with a smaller size bait. Just want to experiment a little bit. Like honestly right now, even a dink, I don't care if it's 0.2 pounds, a fish is a fish right now. I just want to catch a fish. Getting a hit on this rod. Oh no! He got off! No! Oh my god! I'm gonna go ahead and reel it back in. I felt them pull. Thought I had the hook set. Throw this back out there because he got off. Alright, the sun in the way, so I didn't see where that went to. Got my rods and these spiral rod holders here. It's a breeze out here, so my rod is like constantly swaying in the wind. And it was almost hard for me to tell that it was a fish. Thank you. those of you not familiar with the area that I'm fishing with, I'm in Washington, D.C. And every one of my videos in D.C. you probably hear playing. Where I'm fishing at now, I'm probably only about half a mile, three quarters of a mile from the end of the runway where they landing at over at Reagan. So they do fly overhead pretty often. In fact, there's another one coming now. I can see them coming just over the buildings over there across the river. I don't see any more behind him, but they usually come pretty often. And I just want that fish to come back. I got faith though. If I just got a hit, pretty sure it's more to come. That buzz on the small piece of bait too. Like I said, I'm fishing chicken, cut up chicken thighs with a tropical punch Kool-Aid, a little bit of garlic. To Alaska, and I flew out on a plane just like that, one of them long, narrow, skinny planes, and I had a window seat, and I think I was sitting next to a pilot. He had on a pilot's uniform, but I was sitting next to him, and me, I'm actually afraid of heights and flying. I love flying, but the takeoff usually terrifies me. But I think I was just shaking so bad, and like my actions when the plane was taking off just like irritated him, cause I remember I got up, no, he got up. He said, "Hey, I'm going to the restroom," and I remember thinking like, okay, like why does that matter to me? You sitting on the aisle seat, like you don't have to scoot past me to get up or anything. He said, "I'm going to the restroom." And he goes to the restroom, he comes back out, and he grabs his stuff from under the seat and says, "Hey, I'm gonna go sit over here on the other side." And he goes sit on the other side of the plane. I think it was just me. With me moving around, being nervous from the takeoff, I think that's why he got up and moved. I just stepped off, walked to the bathroom. Just now walking back up, and I can see something already just bobbing. Oh yeah, definitely a fish. Definitely a fish on him. He's small though, I could tell that. Small, but he definitely a good size though. I wish. Yeah, he definitely small. He's small. Must be the current, something. fish is a fish. I'm happy. Fish. This video would definitely be on YouTube. I was really thinking, I was away for maybe about 15-20 minutes looking for a restroom around here. Even though I knew where one was at, I just walked the wrong way getting to it. I was really thinking when I got back, it'd be like two slack lines, both rods, you know, two fish, but one is fine, no complaints. Definitely went to the left a little bit. I can't remember if I cast it in that direction or not. Oh no, it's something there. It's definitely something there. Yeah, it's definitely a fish there. No, I wasn't tripping. Could have sworn I threw this line straight out and I come back and it's off to the left somewhere. That's fish number two for the day. So these fish got like these leeches on them or something. I really don't even want to touch them with my bare hands. Even though I have before in the past and they seem pretty harmless. You know, I guess unless you get them stuck to your hands for a long period. But if I don't have to, I prefer not to touch them. I'm gonna go ahead and see if I could just get this up out of here without touching him. Just kinda kick him back in the water. That was on a large piece of bait, guys. So I'm gonna go ahead and throw me another good size bait out there. I really wish I could hook into something. to a nice size, decent size fish. And yes, you just seen me wipe my hand on my backpack because I don't want to wipe my hands on my pants, and I don't have any rags with me. Apparently I lost my glove, my right hand glove that I use to cast my spinning reels with my braided line on there. So I've been going easy casting that other line out there because I don't want to be cutting up my hands with that braid. That was fish number two for the day. Wonder if we could get three or four more in before it get dark on us. Let's see.
Hold up.
Number four right there, guys. Getting it in right now. Hey guys, fish number four. We're going in for five and six right now. got my lines back out. And while I was casting, I just started something. I gotta create like an intro or something for my videos. Like, yeah, like everybody got an intro. Not that I'm trying to be like everybody, but I just wanna have something cool at the beginning of my video. Like how they got a logo for Michael Jordan making a dunk. I make like my own logo, catching a fish or something. Maybe put it on a shirt, so I can sell some shirts. I don't know, something cool. Yeah, we got our lines in the water. Hopefully it don't take long for these next fish. I guess it's prime time now, fish getting ready for dinner. Fish throwing back, tell them go down and tell they homies that there's some Kool-Aid and chicken over here. Anyway guys, if you made it this far in this video, definitely, I'm pretty sure I said this at the beginning. If you made it this far, I'm pretty sure you liking the video, so go ahead. Might as well go ahead right now and hit that thumbs up button. Drop a comment down below. I mean, you don't have to, but everything is appreciated. Hit that subscribe button, because definitely gonna have more cool videos coming up in the future. It's about to be warm, it's about to be summertime, or springtime, it's about to be springtime, then it'll be summertime, of course. So yeah, we're gonna be going to the beach, different places, different states, little hiking trips, mini trips, I call them mini trips. We're doing some awesome things. Probably even do some other stuff. I know my channel called Real Tight Fishing, but we're gonna be doing some other stuff other than fishing. Yeah, really hit that subscribe, thumbs up, drop a comment down below. Alright guys, I'm gonna catch out on the next fish. Alright guys, so I think I'm gonna pull this big rod in here, the black one here. I think I'm gonna go up. So right now I got a small piece of bait on that. I think I'm gonna throw a bigger size bait on there. See if that make a difference in the size fish I catch on it. right there. So looking to plan a trip to, I think I said this in one of my last videos, to the Outer Banks, to Hatteras, I believe it was, I said, yeah, Hatteras, because I've been to Kitty Hawk before, and I've only been as far down as the Oregon Inlet, but other than Hatteras, because I want to make that like a, maybe like a week long trip. I want to take like a little day trip down there, anywhere in North Carolina, do like some fishing for redfish, or some may know them as red drum. Always wanted to catch a shark. I have caught sharks before, just small baby sharks, but I always wanted to catch a shark, like at least 3-4 foot long shark. But yeah, if you guys know any spots down there, got spots to go fishing. I'm pretty sure anywhere is good to go fishing down there. But if you know any good spots, man, any hotels, anything. Virginia Beach. I don't want to go to a large tourist destination, or you know, even though it's not like, you know, tourist season or, you know, summer, a lot of people still probably go there. Yeah, drop it down in the comments below. That's a fish right there, guys. fish number 6, guys. Little dink, but we'll take it. Fish number... Fish number 6, I believe. That was fish number 6. See, maybe we could get 7 to 8. Give him about 25 minutes. That showed up like we might get 15 minutes left before this thing get down. Another 20 minutes, 25 minutes. Definitely want to get out of here before it gets dark, since I don't have my headlamp with me today. Alright guys, so we're finishing off the night with 6 fish. I would like to thank all of you for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it, and just want to let you know, like I probably said many times in this video and in my last video, that there will definitely be more videos coming soon. I'm definitely going to try to be more consistent with my videos, because my last video of me fishing was like 3 weeks ago. I don't want you guys to think I disappeared on y'all. Maybe subscribe to this channel for a reason. Including this night with 6 fish, definitely a great day. I almost thought it was going to be a bad day. I was off to a start with no fish, and then we ended up hooking 6 fish nearly back to back. Yeah, I want to thank you guys for watching this video, and I'm going to definitely catch you guys in the next video.